Hey guys, Double Wide Six here, and today we're going to be talking a little bit about swapping out an engine. Basically what I've just done here is I swapped out an engine on a zero turn. I had a Kawasaki FH500V, as you can see over there on that bucket, and when I bought my tractor, that engine was on there, and basically it was, you could say it like, you could smell it burning oil. And it's gotten worse and worse, and I needed to add about half a quart of oil almost every 8 to 10 hours. So I had a decision to make. It's kind of mid mowing season here. Actually, we're about 2/3 the way through, and I didn't want to be without a mower if I'd rebuild that engine. So I decided I would buy a tractor that had a V-twin engine and a broken transmission. The reason I did that is because I could get that tractor. I bought it for $100, and I went from a 17 horse engine up to a 20 horse engine. The problem is, when you switch an engine, it's not that straightforward. In fact, one time I bought a tractor off a guy, an Exmark, years ago, and the guy I bought it off of says to me, like, you know, it's better to buy a zero-turn tractor with a vertical engine, because vertical engines are all over the place, and if you ever need a new one, you just buy a tractor with a broken transmission and throw one on. Well, that's kind of true, but there's actually a lot of considerations to make when you switch over engines. First of all, when my engine went bad, I called my dealer, my local dealer, and I asked him how much would it cost to replace that engine. So he quoted me a price of $1,600, and that would be for a brand new engine, 17 horsepower, and I don't know if that would come with the muffler, but I don't think so. Maybe the existing muffler I have would fit on, but I wasn't sure, and that was a lot of money. That's probably worth more than this Gravely 144Z that I have it sitting on. So after talking to the dealer, I started looking around for used tractor engines, and that's when I found this one for $100. So what do you have to consider when you get an engine? Well, the first thing that you need to look at is the shaft size of the engine. I know that the engine that I had on there was a 1 inch by 3 5/16, which is a pretty standard size crankshaft. So the new engine happened to have that, so that was good. The next thing that I needed to look at was like the physical size of the engine. You know, is it going to fit within the frame of the tractor? Now, these Briggs overhead valve engines, from 18 to 26, they're all the same size block. So I could have got any engine from 18 to 26, and it should, you know, physically fit in here. As you can see, this thing is a pretty tight fit side to side. And there's also, right there where that silver cap is, that thing's the reservoir for the hydraulic oil. And that butts like right up to the block. So I think I have about maybe a 16th or an 1/8 of an inch clearance. The next thing that you need to consider is the muffler going to work? So this is a standard V-twin muffler that you see on a lot of tractors. And if we bend down here and take a look at this thing, it's very close to the ground. So actually, that muffler is not going to work, so I need to put a new muffler on. And Briggs sells a muffler made for a zero turn that looks something like that, so I actually went ahead and ordered that. The next consideration that you need to make is, when you buy your used engine, what's the charging system look like? I bought this engine knowing that the stator, which is underneath the flywheel, the stator on this original tractor had an AC-DC stator. And yeah, here we go. This is what was on here. So this was actually underneath the flywheel. And this is good for engines that don't have a PTO. So your PTO is your electric clutch, this thing right here. So when you engage the blades, my particular tractor that had the broken transmission, it had like a lever that you'd shift into gear to engage the cutting deck. So it didn't have the right stator. This particular stator, I think it's an AC-DC stator. I think what it does is it produces AC power, which is used for the headlights, and the DC power in this is used to charge the battery, and that's basically how that works. Well, with the engine that I got, I had to switch out the stator, and I had to get a stator that produced, I think you need something like 9 amps to run a PTO at a minimum. So I ended up putting in a 16 amp stator, and it needs to be regulated. So it takes the power, it regulates it, and makes it DC. And I also had to attach a regulator down here. So I added a regulator to the engine. And, you know, once I did all that, this engine was pretty much ready to go. So, you know, luckily the thing fit on the tractor. It had the right crank size. If you have a different crank size or different length, that's going to screw up your belts or your PTO underneath here. Your electric clutch isn't going to fit on that shaft. And yeah, this muffler is just kind of up there temporarily. That's why there's a wire holding it, because I was driving it. I ordered the new one, but it didn't come yet. So those are some, if not all, the considerations that I had to make as far as switching over an engine. I asked my dealer in the beginning how much would it cost for a new engine. He said $1,600. Okay. Then I went on Craigslist. I found this engine. I looked up the model number, and this one, because someone's going to ask, happens to be a 407777. Okay. And I called up the Briggs deal, or my dealer that I was talking to about the Kawasaki, and I said, hey, I'm looking at possibly putting a Briggs engine on there. What I need to know is if I need a new flywheel to run a stator and a regulator, or if I can keep the flywheel that I have. And he was like, oh, I don't know. I'm not sure. You know, we wouldn't advise you doing that, because if you put that engine on, you're going to run into all kinds of electrical problems and your safety switches might not work. And I said, well, you know, I don't have the money for a brand new engine. So, you know, this is kind of the route I want to go. And he said, well, if that's what you want to do, I mean, you might have all kinds of problems, and you know, you can bring it over here and it'll be $70 an hour, and you know, we'll do what we can do and get it in there for you. So I wound up deciding that I would do it myself, and you know, it did take some effort to figure out some things, but I got it done. And you know, I went from a 17 horsepower engine to a 20. Obviously the Kawasaki's, you know, they're a commercial, probably a better engine, but anyhow, this thing's on here, and it's not nearly as loud as that thing, and it doesn't smoke or burn oil or anything. It really runs nice. So I got it all set up, and you know, I'm happy I did it. I learned a few things, and in my next video I'll show you what you have to do to wire up an engine. You know, these dealers, what do they want to do? They want to swap out an engine, so all they have to do is plug it in. And, you know, if you switch from Kohler to Briggs or Kawasaki to Subaru, you're going to have to make wiring adjustments. And you know what? It's really not that hard. There's only about four wires usually hooking up the engine. So like I said, my next video, I will make a link, or talk about how to wire up an engine that you swap over. So I'll fire this thing up and you guys can see it run. I'll show you the RPM on it, and that's pretty much gonna be it. So hang on a sec here. So as you can see, the engine sounds and runs really nice. The top end, I have it set at about 3,300, and the bottom end's at 1,500. I know that this particular engine manufacturer specifies that you can run it at 3,650 for the top end RPM. So anyhow, I wanted to mention this digital tachometer. It's the HS2234. I got this thing on Amazon about 2 months ago. Works really well. I used it a lot in this project because it did take a little fiddling around to get everything adjusted right. And what's cool about it is you just put a little piece of reflective tape on the engine, and it'll pick that up and give you a nice digital reading. It's a lot easier than one of those that you wrap the wire around the spark plug. And this thing was actually less than $20, and I know the other non-contact ones that don't require the reflective tape, they're pretty expensive. I think they're about $60. So I've been using this one, and I really like it better than my other tachometers. So I will put a link underneath to Amazon to get this thing if those of you that are interested. And hopefully any of you that are thinking about swapping over an engine, hopefully you queued in on a couple things that you really need to look at before you go ahead and get the job started. So thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed, I recommend you do. Then you get every video I put up. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Thanks for watching. Check out the link. See ya.